to the Homes and Construction Show. With me today on set, I have a guest. And he has come with a new technique, a unique technique of floors, of flooring your home. For the ones that are there and maybe you want to be unique, or you have maybe heard about it, or you didn't know what it is, worry no more, because you're going to understand what epoxy flooring is. How an epoxy floor looks like.
Okay.
And what is it, especially okay. For the beginners?
Well, an epoxy floor is it's a resin floor that you combine two parts, and once it's laid down, it solidifies into a really hard material, a 100% solid. And it comes in different colors. You can have it as a solid color. You can have it as what they call a metallic color, which kind of shows movement. When you look at it, it almost appears like you're looking at a 3D kind of thing. And we also have it in, you can mix different colors to create different interesting designs that we call dirty pores. So there are different things that you can do with epoxy floors. So it's basically sitting with a client and understanding what they want, what colors they want to go with, and then we can find the appropriate floor for you.
Yes. How different is it from, let me say, the tiles that we have been having, or the normal floors that we have been having?
Well, the first thing is the aesthetics. What we've been accustomed to are tiles that are patterned. And now when you're dealing with epoxy floors, it's giving you a seamless floor. I mean, you look at the floor, there are no joints, there is nothing. We make every effort to make it as flat as possible using some preparation equipment that we have. And then when you pour it, it almost appears like someone laid the glass into your environment, you know. So it's very interesting. Yeah.
So if maybe to consider that, you know how the conventional building has been, where you get your floor covered with cement from here to the other side.
Right.
Should we think that it is the same?
Yes and no, because I mean, underneath we're still going to have the cement. But of course, the key thing that we do here is just prepare that cement, you know, by really leveling it. And then we just apply whatever the epoxy right on top of that. So for us, cement is like a painter would look at it, a canvas. And then it's just about what you do with that canvas. So that's how we basically look at epoxy. Yeah.
So what type of buildings is suitable for an epoxy floor?
It's suitable for both commercial and residential buildings. For residential buildings, you know, you can have it in all areas. You can have it in your living rooms, in your dining rooms. You can have it, you know, literally everywhere in your house. It's suitable for that.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, my worry now is I've seen it shiny.
Yeah.
And that shiny bit or that glossy look has always been accompanied with the slides, the falls, the accidents, in homes. So how is it with epoxy?
Well, with epoxy, I mean, it's pretty much almost like any other kind of flooring in terms of the slip resistance. But what we normally advise is after we're done installing the epoxy, we want to add a top coat. And this top coat might be a polyaspartic or a polyurethane. But we also have some other top coats which reduce the slippage, they reduce on the abrasion, the scratch. It basically adds to the scratch resistance. And then that way, it's not as slippery. So it's right about what you'd get with the tile.
Mm.
Yes.
Like, having that said, can we have a look at those examples of, let me say, the epoxy that has doesn't have that coating of
polyurethane, yes.
That actually prevents the slippery.
Well, the top coats that we add, because they are designed not to take away the beauty of the epoxy, so they are clear, right? So it might be difficult for someone to tell exactly if a floor has a top coat or not. We recommend that people add a top coat in order to, again, you know, increase on that abrasion resistance, scratch resistance, slip resistance. But one very important component is the UV protection, because epoxy by itself doesn't have UV protection. So eventually, if it's being hit by sunlight and stuff like that, it might yellow a little bit. So that's the reason why you want to put a top coat, and that top coat will basically give you the UV protection that you need.
Now, speaking of the UV protection,
yes,
and combining your statement here, you told me that we can use epoxy everywhere in the house.
Yes.
So I'm assuming, having it in my kitchen,
yes,
and you know how ladies are,
yeah,
with cooking, you just carry your kettle from the
right,
and then
right,
you just perhaps press it right away on the floor,
right,
or maybe you have a charcoal stove,
right.
What are the effects now?
Well, there is epoxy is quite resistant to heat, but I don't have the actual temperature with me right now, but it's quite resistant to heat. But I would not advise you to get like
hot,
you know,
things,
a charcoal stove or something that's extremely hot, and just lay it on top of that. I wouldn't recommend that.
So we may say that epoxy is our high-end product that needs that sensitive care. It needs a lot of care, really.
It needs some care. It needs, but it's almost like any other floor. You need to take care of it. You need to take care of it. You need to know that you're not going to bring things that are super hot and put them right on it. You need to know that you're not going to, you know, get things that are like knives and go on, you know. Or maybe if you're using it like on a countertop, you're not going to also turn it into your cutting board. You know what I mean?
I can use it at the countertop.
Oh yes, oh yes.
So how long has epoxy been here in Uganda? And how are Ugandans really adopting to it?
Epoxy has been here for a while. I'm not sure really how many years, but probably we've seen a lot of it in the last 6 to 10 years. But it was mostly being used at the industrial level. But now I'm seeing a lot more people wanting to put it into their homes. And that's really what is trending at the moment. Yes.
So where do you get the motivation or the inspiration to focus on epoxy? Much as I've seen other types of floors,
right,
but where do you get that inspiration to be like, it is something I should venture in?
Right. I mean, like everywhere that I have been in Uganda, every home, every building, or let me say most, when you go and everyone has tiles, right?
True.
And with epoxy, I think a lot of it is the ability to get something different without just walking into a store and saying, I'm going to buy this tile in this pattern and that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
With epoxy, it gives you the ability to create different, amazing things. And no one floor is going to look like the other.
Mm-hmm.
So um, if I might buy the same product mm-hmm. for my home and you buy the same product for your home, but when you lay it, your floor is going to be slightly different from mine, or very different, just depending on how it's been installed.
Okay, by saying that, you want to tell us that the expertise you have mm-hmm. is so far the best in the country? I'm just asking.
I would like to think so.
Because
I'd like to think that if we did a sample, mm-hmm. It would be very hard to compete against us with mm-hmm. our products. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What does one really need mm-hmm. to have an epoxy installed in their home?
Well, there are a couple of scenarios that we run into. Mm. One of them might be someone that hasn't yet laid the concrete. They haven't yet screeded. Mm. And, we might be required to do a screed before we then do the epoxy.
The screed?
Screed, yes. Like the screed, that the layer that you'd add on of cement and sand. Mm. And then after that would come and put the epoxy on top of that. Mm. That could be one scenario. You could find another scenario where they've already done the screeding and then you just go and level out the floor and then again you do the epoxy. Mm. But then you also have people that have existing floors.
Exactly.
Like so, someone has tiles.
And they're interested now.
And they're now interested in going with epoxy. Mm-hmm. Then, you know, what do you do with that? We can actually come through. We have ways that we can actually cover up the tile and then just go on top with the epoxy. Mm. Yeah.
So for the water-filled areas, let me say swampy areas, wetlands, is it favorable to have an epoxy?
It depends on all the preparation that has been done to limit the amount of moisture that is coming through the floor. Mm. But we have epoxies that are designed for areas that might be prone to moisture coming through. Mm. And when we use that epoxy, it reduces the moisture that might come through the floor. But they have some moisture meters that you can use to measure the amount of moisture that's coming out of the floor. Mm. And that will allow you to make the determination on what kind of epoxy you're going to use.
Mm. Yeah. So, for instance, a house, let me give an example of like a two-bedroom house.
Yes.
What is the estimation of the amount of materials of epoxy that would be needed for them to have their homes complete?
Like a two-bedroom house?
Mm-hmm. Two-bedroom with a sitting room, then maybe a dining, they have a kitchen, these rooms are self-contained.
Right.
Yeah, tentatively.
You'd need about...
You can say, because I'm saying buckets or tins.
Yes,
you can,
yes. We'll probably need about 4 or 5 kits.
By a kit, what do you mean?
A kit comes in, like the kits that we carry, come in, like you have to mix them 2 to 1. Mm. It's a part A and a part B. So you'd get the part A and mix it with the part B. So all together, it would almost, a kit would have about 11.3, 11.4 liters in it.
Wait a minute. For a whole house, you can use like 11 liters?
No. That's one kit. That is one kit.
Okay.
Exactly. That is one kit. Mm. And one kit, depending on the kind of flooring you're doing, might cover about 7 square meters.
7 square meters.
Yes.
Like a kit can cover around 7 square meters.
Yes.
So do we have different types of epoxy? And if we do, what are they?
Well, we have Well, for epoxy, it's just what we're going to do to it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because it comes as clear, right? And then, yes, it comes as a clear resin. Mm. And then what we do is we just add the pigments to it.
So you can decide to get the pigments of a sitting room different from the ones of maybe a veranda.
That is correct. That is correct.
So it means that a level or the space where you're applying it to determine that. Because I'm taking you on the tiles. Eh?
Yes.
You know, you can have floor tiles.
Yes.
Then we can have maybe wall tiles.
Wall tiles, yes.
Eh?
Yes.
So it is the same thing when it comes to...
Yes, it's the same thing. The difference is that when you go to a store and you buy tiles, you buy a certain color, right? But here you can buy the resin, the epoxy, it will come clear. And then just depending on what you want for the different areas, we can add the different colors.
Oh.
Yes.
So it means I can still tell you that I desire to have a certain color in my sitting room.
Yes. Yes.
So you have all colors. I want black, I get.
Yes.
I need cream.
Yes. We have up to 74 different color combinations that we can do. And we actually have, I have a few samples here that you can see. Yeah. Well, this is just a board. It's just a board. We basically put these boards together to kind of, at least if someone walks in here, at least we know that they can get the look and feel of what epoxy is, and also decide what color they might want to have and where they might want to put it. You know.
So when done, this is how
it
is going to look like. What's the suppose these various types of epoxy?
Well, depending on where you're going to use it, like for example, we have epoxy, the epoxy resin, but we also have what they call a polyaspartic. And polyaspartics are mostly used in areas that there might be like a lot of traffic. And it's also one of the products that we use as a top coat to protect the epoxy. So if you're using it in a place like, for example, a hospital or something like that, you might want to add a solid color to it.
Yeah, I can use it also in a hospital.
Yes, you can.
Because I see a lot of traffic.
Or even schools and stuff like that, yes, yes.
You know, when you when we talked about its sensitivity and care, I didn't even imagine that it can be in places with a lot of traffic.
Yes,
for instance, the hospital and the school.
Yes, and even more so like industry, where you have all of these forklifts driving around, turning around on it. Basically, it's also strong enough for industrial use. Yes. And in fact, all the early adaptions of epoxy here, I believe, were industrial.
Sure.
Yes, so it's really hard. It's really hard, yeah.
So what differentiates the epoxy floors from these other types of floors?
One, the seamlessness. Two, there are things like, for example, when you think of a tile, you have all of these grout lines here. And these are areas where bacteria likes to reside, you know. So when you have an epoxy floor
maybe
that is
seamless, maybe for someone with a poor hygiene.
Well, it depends. You'll be surprised at how much stuff gets in between those tiles. Yeah, so with an epoxy floor, it's really easy to clean, easy to maintain. And it can serve you for many, many, many years.
If you talk of many years, if you, to be specific, how many years can I have an epoxy before changing it?
At least 10 years.
At least 10 years.
Yes.
So what do I do after 10 years? I come back?
After 10 years, it depends on, do you want to keep the same floor or do you want to change? Yeah, because after the first install, it actually becomes a lot cheaper to change.
Why?
Because a lot of the work that goes into installing epoxy is around the preparation. So if the floor is already there, it's already flat, all you do is come with a sanding machine and just lightly sand it, and then you can go over with another coating, or if you wanted to change the colors, you wanted to change the pattern, you wanted to change whatever, you just go over that, and so it will be cheaper.
Cheaper if you're getting a second maybe round of...
Exactly. If you want to change it, yes.
Okay.
But then you can also, if you wanted to maintain the same, you can come and lightly sand it, and then when you come with a top coat, it basically, you know, it renews it, it restores it.
So how about the maintenance? How do you advise, or how do we maintain epoxy floors?
I'll just recommend using a light detergent with water.
Light detergent, you mean what?
Like, what is it called? Like, you know, the regular cleaning soap that we use.
Like liquid soap?
Liquid soap, like, yes, that's the word I was looking for, yes. Like liquid soap, a little bit mild and, yeah.
Because, okay, sorry, but I'm taking you back. Mm-hmm. When you say light detergents,
yes,
and then you also advise that it can actually be used in hospitals.
Yes.
We've seen hospitals use Shong detergent.
Yes.
They will use Jik,
yes,
because they want the bacteria to be,
yes,
killed.
Yes.
Now,
yes,
what reaction is it going to... are we going to have when we are
chemicals,
using, yeah, with the chemical?
I don't have the list in front of me, but I have it's resistant to very, very many chemicals, so that wouldn't be a problem. I think the only area where you might have a bit of an issue is if you're using that something that is very aggressive to try and clean it, then you might kill like the glossiness and stuff like that. Yes.
And then the brushes, because you see us in homes, eh?
Yes.
There are times when you're now scrubbing, you want to scrub the whole house, then you get your brush, and you're like, isn't it? Doesn't it affect the beauty or the glossiness of our epoxy?
Well, of course, if you looked at it over a long time, yes, it will. But typically, you'll find that the floors are resistant to a lot of chemicals and things like that. So you'll find that they're really easy to clean, and you might not have the need to actually get like a rough brush and like aggressively brush it.
We've been here, you have heard. For some of you, I think I've come across these floors, but you know how people are. They will never tell you that this is this. They'll always try to dodge around the question. They will not tell you where they get the products from. But the advantage is that Urban TV is here. The Homes and Construction Show is here. For us, we'll always go out there, look for anything that is trending, and we bring it to you right on your screens. So today we have looked at epoxy floor. We haven't finished. We are coming back in our next segment, or that is next week. We are still going to look at the maintenance. We are going to look at the price. We are going to look at the durability, even the way of application. So do not even think of changing your dial, because we are here for you. Thank you for being with us. And from me and my entire crew, we are saying bye-bye.